Hey, everybody, it's time for your Browns Friday Fumble.
All on it.
Don't try to pick it up and run unless you're Joe Schobert. He picked it up. He ran, breaking the cardinal rule of the Friday Fumble. And you see what happened, Dylan?
I do see what happened.
You see what the consequences of those actions are,
yeah, real
Dylan?
Browns tough loss.
Tough Browns loss. No thanks to you, Joe Schobert. You should have fell on it. I mean, I know you were able to advance the ball quite far, yeah. But what does that say to your team? What does that say to everybody?
Yeah.
You're saying you don't have confidence in the offense, so you're going to try to run the ball yourself? The offense has the job. You got the ball. That's your job, Mr. Defense.
You did it.
Your job is not to run it back. So
fall on it.
Stuff looks bad. It looks bad here in Brownstown. I know you guys listen to...
Let's not put lipstick on a pig here, Dave.
No.
Stuff is looking bad.
It's looking bad, and Dylan and I were done before, and admittedly, we're not done now, but we're deeply, deeply concerned.
Yeah, I'm definitely not done.
You ever had a thing where, you know, you did something to upset your dad, and he wasn't mad, he was just kind of disappointed?
Yeah.
That's where I'm at.
I'm
not mad. I'm the Browns' dad right now.
I'm not done.
But I expect...
But stuff looks bad.
First of all, I don't just expect. I deserve wins from this team. I deserve them.
And look, Dave, if they don't want to show up and deliver on that promise that they have made us, me, personally...
Yeah.
On a Sunday night?
Sunday
after night. Hours? Sunday after hours?
Yeah, darkness has fallen. You know what? Okay. I'm going to level with you. Things are bad. Things are not going great on the Browns. It looks like Dorsey doesn't know what he's doing. Well... Oh. Hold on, Dylan. Hold on for a second.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, we're back. Roster rebuild. Dorsey isn't doing enough. He's not put out into the bushes for NFL talent.
Yep.
So we're taking it upon ourselves to do this. But
yep.
You know what? It's late right now.
Uh-huh.
Dylan and I, we've got jobs, okay?
Yeah.
Besides
being Browns insiders, yes.
Yeah. We're also insiders at our jobs.
At the job that I'm going to wake up for tomorrow morning.
Right.
Yep.
So we've upped the ante.
Yep. A little bit.
We just went to Marshall Yanda Express. We got some Szechuan hot chicken. Stopped off at the S-Bucks. Got about a gallon of cold brew.
Far too much, Dave.
And we're going to use every resource available to us and the NFL to fix this roster.
Yes.
Dorsey's unwilling to do it. He's busy wearing a sweatshirt and shorts.
I am so ready to do this right now.
Let's do it.
Yep.
Baker,
yep.
You look discombobulated.
He's the quarterback for anybody who's wondering.
Discombobulated quarterback, not seeming himself. You had a good rookie year, but now it's time to redshirt you. Let's put the red shirt you.
Sit and rest, friend.
Don't have to look far. Garrett Gilbert, already under contract, already on the roster,
already
knows the plays.
He's in the trailer.
He proved in the AAF he's got what it takes. New quarterback, Garrett Gilbert. You're hired. Baker,
done.
Watch, hold, clipboard.
Bingo, bam, zoinko.
Running back. Next, running back. I called up Madden. I hit best players available in Madden for my franchise mode.
Yes.
Frank Gore.
Available on Madden right now. Look at it.
That's an overall 80 running back. I don't even remember what Nick Chubb is, but I doubt it's an 80. It might be more than an 80, but guess what?
Not sure.
You can never have two 80s. That's fine. You can do that. And I think Madden is legally binding, even though Google said he's on the Bills.
It's fine.
So we're going with it.
It's fine. You know what checks out there, Dave?
Yeah.
Wins in the win column.
The W
column. Right
now,
Frank Gore has a lot of them.
Yeah, a lot of them. We don't. Okay, next, wideout.
Yes.
Top tier, first two wideouts.
Yeah.
Start to go down the roster. Not great. You know who isn't injured right now?
I do, Dave. And you know His name is DeAndre Hopkins.
Yeah, got him on my fantasy team. About to have him on my reality team.
Yeah, yeah. Hopkins International Airport, ring a bell?
Yeah, you think that if Dorsey doesn't dangle a third rounder up in front of the Texans, that they're not going to bite at that deal?
Seriously. That
get out of my town.
What is he even doing at work?
Get out of my town. Big hole. Next, tight end. Big hole.
Oh, my God. It's a crevasse.
The Chiefs on the IR. You can't do the fade to him. He can't do the Chief Slam. What are you going to do?
It's a cheat code, Dave.
It's a cheat code that we no longer have access to up, down, left, right, A, B.
My God.
We don't have it anymore.
All he does is do a little play action handoff.
Then he's open. And then he's taller than everybody else. So we're going to do what they've done in the past that no one is thinking of doing right now. We're going to go the old Antonio Gates route.
Mm-hmm.
We are going to call Kent State. Mm-hmm. We're going to talk to the Golden Flash's basketball coach.
Easy.
Not talk to the football coach. He's got football players. We need to get CJ Williamson, guard, 6'7",
yep.
Kent State basketball.
Yep.
Hand him a helmet.
Easy.
Give him a pamphlet that tells him the basic rules and go for it.
All he's got to do is jump and catch.
Jump.
He already does
catch.
It. He already
jump,
does it. Jump, catch, and run. A little bit of
adjust
running.
Adjust your hands
problem.
In a little bit because the ball's slightly different shape. But once you do that, you're fine.
We should really give some of these guys some nitro brew because it is really
it
working.
Really,
right now.
O-line. Got to do something.
Uh-huh.
Do you see Aaron Donald? Average guy made him look like a superstar last week.
God.
You made him look like a superstar.
He was finding holes in the ground.
You want to know the best way to look like a great defensive player? Up against the Browns line right now.
I guess so.
What is going on?
It's just crazy.
And you know what?
Where
I don't know
gonna,
anything about offensive line. I don't know.
Where are we going to look, Dave?
Nobody but a real Jake Burns type knows about the offensive line.
You got that right.
I mean, Joe Thomas, I don't think he's coming back. He lost all the weight. He's too skinny now.
I don't think so. I don't think he can.
What about that dude who bullied the other dude?
Weight minimum?
Is the bully dude still around?
Oh, I wish.
What about the dude that he bullied? Does he want to try it again and say we'll be nicer to him this time?
Yeah, we got plenty of slots.
Wait.
We got plenty
of
holes.
Wait. Just thought of it. Guy from Ballers.
Oh, my God.
O-lineman.
Oh, my God, you're blowing my mind. You're blowing the top of my cranium off right now, Dave.
Guy from Ballers.
Holy
not the Rock, not the Rock.
Smokes.
He's busy.
You just made my entire day with that statement.
Me too. I made my day.
Holy smokes.
Okay, that's the offense.
Wow. That was a big rush.
Yeah, let's keep power through.
Okay.
Power through here.
Right.
Defense.
Yep.
D-line.
Yep.
Solid.
Yeah.
No Don't problem. Need to mess with it.
I wouldn't touch it.
Okay. Linebackers.
Yes.
One step back from the D-line. Kirko is hurt-o.
No doubt about it.
The rookies?
Doing okay.
Taki Taki, Alvin Mack doing okay.
Like those dudes.
But Dylan.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what to do about these linebackers.
I don't either.
I don't know what to do about
it. Just get hurt.
They just get hurt,
they
and then
the
other guys
balls?
Come in. Yeah, not.
They run them?
Schobert?
Schobert rated.
Yeah, I can't even do it anymore. These linebackers.
Yeah.
Dylan, I don't know if I can do this. I'm not Dorsey. I'm not Dorsey, Dylan.
Dave, you don't need to be Dorsey. You just need to think of a good linebacker that doesn't have a job right now.
Googling it. I Googled it. Kevin Minter. Let's get Kevin Minter.
Sign him
linebacker,
right
free
Sign
agent
him.
Linebacker, Kevin Minter. Defensive back.
This is so easy.
We're
this
on
is
scraps.
So easy.
We're on scraps. We're on scraps with the DBs. We already got a guy off the street.
Yeah. Well,
what are
we
the,
did.
What do the Dolphins go, have? The Dolphins, the tanking. Nobody wants to play there. What do they got?
Fire
50,
sale.
50 bucks. What do they got? Somebody Google Dolphins cornerback. Google it. I'm not Googling it. I don't want it to think I'm a Dolphins fan.
We got to wait till Saturday
what
and
am
go
I?
Down there for a yard sale because
that's
am I? Where they all are.
What am I, Jeff Nomina, trying to get Dolphins players on my team? I don't need that, Jeff.
They're down there with a bunch of He-Man action figures from the late 80s.
Yeah, and like 25 cents? I don't think so. Why don't you call me when the GameCube's up for sale? I'm not Dorsey. I'm not Dorsey. Dylan, I don't feel right doing this, and I just kind of don't feel right in general right now. I'm going to sit down. All right, guys. It's tomorrow. We both had a good sleep.
I just slept for about 14 hours.
You know that thing about the day jobs? They're not real happy.
I just got fired.
Dylan's now an outsider at his day job. So we're really going to have to double down on this Browns insider thing because the work insiders no longer. So bottom line, if we can't improve the roster, we need to clue you guys in on some stuff. And
yeah, thankfully, we still have our connections up in Berea.
Now, don't worry, because you're going to, when we tell you this, I mean, this is not a secret agent spy novel. This message will not self-destruct.
It might feel that way for a little bit. Don't worry.
Don't worry. I have encrypted this episode. It is only listenable by Browns fans. So no one else is going to know what we're about to say. So don't worry that what we're telling you mm-hmm. is going to affect the team in any way.
Mm-hmm.
But let's just say you're one of like most of the fans in this town and you're a complete fucking dipshit moron. You're saying, oh man, Freddie seems like a dumb hick. Baker looks like a dumb fucking hick. Well, guess what? Guess who's the dumb fucking hick? You piece of shit.
All right, well, I
you slimy piece of shit.
I would more call them naive, I feel like.
You know what? It's willful naivete. But,
okay,
fine.
I'll grant you that.
Let's get into the explanation. We'll get into
I think we should.
Okay.
Yeah. Then they'll understand.
Dylan, 80% of the coaches in the NFL are playing checkers.
You're right.
Sean McVay,
yep.
Bill Belichick, Pat Shermer, they're playing Chinese checkers. They're a step ahead of the other guys. They're a step ahead, you know.
That's the marble one.
The marbles.
Mm-hmm. With the triangles.
Freddie Kitchens,
mm-hmm.
he's playing chess. And he's not only playing chess, he's playing that battle chess that you had on your old computer.
Yeah, my Mac Plus.
Yeah. Everything was animated, the graphics mm-hmm. like the rooks walking around and stuff and
super realistic.
At minimum, that's what Freddy's doing. Okay. So
it's really beyond even that.
Yeah.
Freddy here, he's playing Catan.
You know what? You're right. He's got basically in his initial town positioning,
mm-hmm.
he went, you know what? I'm going to need bricks early.
You always need bricks early, guys.
To build my roads.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to need wheat until later.
Never do.
So, okay, I'm not going to explain it all this way. Let's go back to football, because really football's simpler.
Right, right.
Look, let me clue you idiots in.
Naive fan base.
Everybody's sitting here screaming, oh, the Browns lost. The Browns lost to an opponent they had a chance to win. Guess what? No one gives a crap about a non-division, non-conference opponent this early in the season. He's not going to use his good plays in this game.
Why would you?
And it's not only that. Like, he's not going to use it because he doesn't want to use them. He doesn't need to use them, first of all. Other aspect of this, it's misdirection. He needs to put the bad stuff down on film.
Guys, have you ever heard of a bullpen game?
Yeah.
This is what we're talking about here.
So you're thinking Sunday Night Football, national TV.
Everyone's watching.
time for the Browns to shine. But guess what? You know what the other teams are doing while the Browns are playing?
Christ, Dave.
They're watching the game.
They're watching the damn game.
They're taking notes. Everybody watches Sunday nights.
Yes.
They're all playing at 1 p.m., so they can't watch that game.
Yeah.
And most teams don't have Sunday tickets.
Why would they need it?
They can't.
They are the NFL.
And they can't watch.
Why would they?
You know what? The NFL gives them a Game Pass discount that is very generous.
It is very generous.
But nobody can afford it.
We had access to it 3 years ago.
Nobody can afford it. So they, if they don't catch the game live, they're not seeing it.
They can't watch it. They're playing the game.
So when you're playing this team that I frankly had never even heard of before Sunday night, the Rams, you're starting to say to yourself, why would I want to run my good plays against this team that I don't even think they're in our league?
Why would I burn my good plays?
On an exhibition game. It's practically an exhibition game.
You might as well take them out back, put them in
the fire
pit. Might
as well be playing in the NFL rock and jock game with Dan Cortez and
25-point
baskets. And yeah, and it's like, this is for show. It doesn't matter.
So look, your division rivals are all watching Sunday night, because otherwise, look, you play on 1 o'clock on Sunday. Who else is playing? Pittsburgh.
Everybody.
Baltimore.
Yeah. Everybody.
Cincinnati.
Yeah.
So they're all watching. You have to feed the misdirection.
You guys, I know I was harsh earlier.
Sow the seeds. You got to sow the seeds.
You guys, and I apologize for being harsh earlier. I got to say, you guys, we know our audience is a step above the normal fan.
Right.
So we're going to talk to you in some football talk.
Q's and T's are coming now.
Yeah.
So get out your pens and your pencils.
You've heard of a play action fake where you're faking the run to throw the pass?
Mm-hmm.
This entire game was a play action fake for the rest of the year.
Yep.
If you don't think that Mike Tomlin and whichever Harbaugh is in Baltimore and whoever since he got isn't going to bite hard on this fake.
You got another thing coming, buddy.
You'd think, you know, you guys know football. I told you that. You guys know football. The idiot reporters in this town, though.
Oh, my God, these guys.
They're too busy asking about trivial nonsense about OBJ's watch and what Rex Ryan said and about questionable fourth and not nine play calls and Baker not looking like himself.
Yeah, we just watched the tape, by the way. He looks exactly like
him. It looks exactly like him. He doesn't even have the mustache. It's just kind of back to beard. Jake Burns, I know you're a friend.
We
love you and all that. And you're getting close to this. Close.
Really, really, really close. You're almost there.
But you're not there yet. You have a lot to learn. Guess what? You figured out how to break down film. You can see what's going on, but you really don't know the why, and you very much don't know the when.
Absolutely not.
So it's like you've seen a video of the moon landing, but you can't give me directions on how to get there. You just saw it. You said, oh, yeah, they landed on the moon. And you're like, great.
Yeah, what are you a rocket?
Yeah, what are you, a rocket now? You're not.
Come on.
So it's really time for you naive snowflakes to realize what's going on. It's time to take the brown pill and wake up. You don't need to panic. You don't need to panic. Freddie has this all under control. John Dorsey has this under control. And beyond that, get a mop ready because your mind's about to be blown. And keep in mind, encrypted. No one else knows this.
Nobody can understand it but you.
The man who set this all in motion has it under control.
And who's that, Dave?
That man is Sashi Brown.
You're damn right.
He is still the puppet master. He is still running things. And he took it, him getting, quote, fired, unquote, to keep his plan going. Fine. Did you watch House of Cards?
Mm-hmm.
How about House of Yards? 100 yards on a football field. That's what's happening.
Notice this dude is not employed in the NFL.
Nope.
Dave.
Nope. He got hired by the Washington Wizards, but that's just a cover. Cause
you know who's signing those checks?
Yep. His name's Jimmy. Yeah, he can't be unemployed forever because people would say, why is this brilliant man still unemployed? So, let me sum it up. In Sashi we trust. Let him pull the strings and ride this train all the way to the goddamn Super Bowl. You're welcome to stay on. If you want to panic at the first sign of a little blip on your radar.
Adversity training.
Guess what? If those brave boys in WW2 would have panicked when a little blip came up on their radar, you'd be speaking German right now. All right? So why don't you nut up, learn something, apply that knowledge, and just be patient. Sashi's got this. You don't need to worry. And guess what? When you line up against Baltimore this week, and they think you're going to run the bad plays, you're going to run the good plays, and they are going to be essing bricks when they see them. So, unencrypt mode. Now everybody else can hear the rest of the episode. All they heard during that part was just weird squiggle noises.
So now, Dave, we got a new segment here. We're gonna open up our email browser here and take a look at some Browns Friday Fumble emails.
Yeah, let's do it. Of course, if you want to email us. Dylan, what's, hold on. It's Browns Friday Fumble email us segment at Browns Friday Fumble email dot mindspring.net.
That's the address for the emails, and that's where we will collect them in our inbox on a weekly basis. And if you want your email to get on the air with us, and us to answer your questions, feel free to use that address. Dave, what was that again?
That was Browns Friday Fumble email segment at brownsfridayfumble.mindspring.net.
Perfect. All right.
And
so
if you really want to get it read, you're going to want to Venmo us $5 at Browns Friday Fumble email segment at brownsfridayfumble.mindspring.net.
Now, and I did just lose my job, so that will be very, 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 very good to get some of those in. Okay, so let's crack this first one open. This one's coming from Sophia Cardwell out of East Lake, and it says, Dear Davin and Ryan, I assume that's probably...
Yeah, I don't know.
That's probably us. I enjoyed your radio program where you discussed the players of the Jets football roster very much. I was able to share many laughs with my nephew Alexander on Friday afternoon whilst listening to them. Your whimsical take on the sport of football, and more precisely the Browns, is quite refreshing after a loss. And here comes the questions.
Rapid fire from Sophia here.
Yeah. Number one, Nathan Zagura is very handsome. Do you boys know him? That's number one.
Actually, surprise treat. We happen to have Nathan Zagura sitting right here with us right now.
Hello, Nathan.
Now, we're going to finish Sophia's questions first, and then we'll come back and talk to you, Nathan, so just hold tight.
Number two, we haven't heard much about Moose Dog lately. Has he been a good boy? That's... really good question there, Sophia.
The Browns haven't really told us, and while we are insiders, I'm going to assume he's been a good boy.
And finally, number three from Sophia Cardwell out of East Lake. Do you think defensive coordinators are showing Baker a cover two but bleeding into a cover six with man coverage on the under at the snap in order to confuse his rhythm?
I'm going to say yes. Yes, Sophia. I'm going to go with yes.
That one... Yeah, so... the cover two.
Yeah, I think they are doing that, Sophia.
Yeah, you're probably right about that.
They're doing that.
Mm-hmm.
All right, as we teased earlier, big time guest for us. We've been fans for a long time.
Long time listeners.
Host of Cleveland Browns Daily on the Cleveland Browns Radio Network, Nathan Zagura, famous sideline reporter. We're just huge fans, Nate. Can I call you Nate? Thanks.
That's really nice of you.
Yeah. So, been doing this for a long time.
Foremost, Dave, we must ask on behalf of Sophia. Nathan, can you give Sophia a little shout out either on Cleveland Browns Daily or right now? Okay. Yeah. Oh, she's gonna love that. my goodness.
Thank you. Okay, so Nate, let's know some details about you, the person. How did you find yourself in Cleveland, and how did you get involved with the Browns?
Oh my God, I didn't.
With a hatchet? Huh. Well, you know, it's everybody has their own interview style, so that's interesting.
Well, that's amazing.
You know, I would be remiss. Dylan and I are real journalists. I would be remiss not to bring up the situation last year when you were suspended by the NFL for arguing with the refs. We know you have a lot of passion that you demonstrated, and we as
We appreciate
Browns
it so
fans,
much.
We appreciate it so much. But what exactly did you say to the ref that angered him so?
Nate, the city of Cleveland awaits with bated breath.
Yes. Well, I don't think that's that bad.
My God, that's... Oh, I mean, you're just speaking your mind.
You're just speaking your mind, and also...
What, is this America?
Yeah, and also... Okay, call me crazy, but that happened over 35 years ago, so he's got to be over it by now.
Whoa, okay, all right.
Fair enough.
That's funny.
Fair enough.
That's really,
all right.
Really funny.
Okay, but my that goodness. One was worth the suspension right there to get
my
that
gosh.
One off.
My gosh.
All right, Nate, let's wrap it up with one more question. You get to interact with the biggest stars on the Browns, the Myles Garretts, the Baker Mayfields, the Odell Beckhams. Tell us a funny Odell Beckham story from training camp this year.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Oh.
No, he did not.
The entire ham sandwich? That's incredible. Like, I knew he had talents. I didn't know he had that many talents.
I would imagine that he was pretty mad about that. No.
Wow. I didn't realize we were going to get a story that Myles Garrett was also involved in. But man, I did not anticipate that any of that would have happened in that way that you just precisely described. I can't
That's
see their arms fitting together like that.
I believe this might be an exclusive.
Yeah,
to Browns
talk
Friday
about
Fumble.
Insiders. Wow.
My goodness.
Whew.
Nathan, I can't thank you enough.
Yeah, you know what? It has been a blast. You know what? I really appreciate it. We do the show for the fans, and you saying that you love our show and listen to it every week and would promote it on Browns Daily if you were allowed means a lot to us. A lot to us, and it just really makes it satisfying because, as you know, Dylan just lost his job, and he's just trying to get back on his feet, and, you know, it really makes it all worth it, the amount of hours we put in on this.
Nathan, I have 5 kids.
So. But yes, in short, to answer your question, yes, Dylan and I will absolutely join you on Cleveland Browns Daily as often as you want. Just say the call and we will be down there. Just say the word whenever. We accept your invitation wholeheartedly.
Yeah, Nathan, thanks for being here, Nathan.
Thanks a lot, Nathan. We really appreciate it. You know, it's a little bit late, but it might be time to...
Know your foe.
Baltimore Ravenclaws.
Let's fire this thing up, Dave. Are you ready to hear about him? Our foe?
I'll tell you one thing.
The original foe?
I'll tell you one thing. I'm tired of him already. Tired of him already.
Dave, right off the rip on the offensive side of the ball, we got 7-up spokesman Orlando Brown Jr.
Former NFL running back and sequel Mark Ingram, 3.
Kung Fu Marshall Yanda.
Your nephew, Hayden Hurst.
This one is kind of special, Dave.
Yeah.
Willie Snead, the f***ing 4th.
The 4th.
He's the 4th, y'all.
Thanks, Willie 3, Willie 2, and Willie 1. At Wideout, famous tech blogger, MKBHD, Marquise Brown.
BMX pro, Matt Skura.
Miles Boykin, known primarily for his breakthrough jazz session recordings, Birth of the Uncool.
God, Dave, football team, and they even stole our goddamn rock and roll legend, Ronnie Stanley Band.
Muffler Shop, Gus Edwards.
Car You Take to Funerals, James Hurst.
Austin Powers' younger brother, Ben Powers, whose catchphrase is, "Yes, baby."
Bluetooth speaker, Bradley Bozeman.
Former Brown, Robert Griffin, III.
And finally, Dave, the greatest quarterback to be a part of any football team that has ever existed, past or present.
Real or fictional.
Lamar Jackman, or Jackson.
Yeah. And it's pronounced lamer. On the defense, brother of Americana folk singers, Seth and Scott Averett brothers, Anthony Averett brother.
Oscar the Grouch's trash can companion, Chris Wormley.
Nanny, Pernell McPhee.
Famous herbivore from Triassic period, Patrick Onwasore.
What you say when you just need a draw to win a tournament in Super Mario Strikers? Tie us, Bowser!
50th state, Otaro, Alaska.
Piece of wood, Chris Board.
Game show legend, Chuck Clark.
Moving on up to strong safety, Tony Jefferson.
Running for city council in Ward 3, voting takes place on November 5th, Tim Williams.
Japanese noodles, Matthew Udon.
And Anthony Levine Sr., look, dude, we get it. You had sex. Good for you.
Guess what? Someday we will, too. And now on to special teams. You know what? F*** their special teams. All right, Dylan.
I know what time it is.
We rebuilt the roster.
Done.
Talked about the Ravens roster.
Done.
Had a wonderful guest.
Just really nice.
Still kind of glowing in here from that. Mm-hmm. Now it's time to predict. It's time to what, you know, you've lasted this long in the episode. Good job for you. We got a little abusive there. You had to deal with some substance abuse issues there. That's a lot. It's a lot to unpack, but this is why you're here. It's for the predictions. Dylan.
Yes.
Browns, Ravens. Currently, the Ravens are favored by 7 puentos. That seems absurd to me. What do you think is going to happen this week?
You're
keeping
me.
In mind,
yeah, go ahead. Yep.
that Baltimore does have the best quarterback that has ever been assembled.
Yeah. I can't get on the hype train, Dave. This is Baltimore we're talking about.
Yeah.
Not vaunted at all.
They are not vaunted. They've played remarkably unvaunted teams this year.
Mm-hmm.
The Chiefs fairly vaunted, and you saw how that turned out for them.
Yeah, poorly. I'll tell you what is going to happen, Dave. We're going to march into Baltimore.
Q&T Bank Stadium.
We are going to lay down 26 points.
Okay.
Baltimore, they're going to lay down 17 points.
Mm.
We are going to win this game because the real playbook's coming out this week, Dave.
I agree with you there. And I also will say this, that the only reason we are only going to score 26, and again, I agree with you this week that it is going to be 26-17.
Amazing.
The only reason we limit ourselves to 26 is because we still got Pittsburgh and Cincy coming.
Can't burn the whole playbook.
Can't burn, don't need to.
Shouldn't.
Like timeouts, you don't need to use them, don't use them.
Let them roll over.
They roll over, you can storm in your account with Apple Pay now. Timeouts are available on Apple Pay. So, yeah, if you don't need to use the good plays and you're still going to win with a comfortable 9-point victory,
mm-hmm.
then do it. And so, yeah, I agree with you. 26-17 Browns.
Wonderful.
On the road. If you're a betting man, I don't know what to tell you. That's shit's evil.
So we're sorry, Miss Jackson.
We're sorry, Miss Jackson. Never meant to make your son cry. But I think Miles Garrett probably is going to do that.
Browns win 26-17.
Take it to the M&T Bank Stadium. All right, everybody. Thank you for listening. Thank you to Nathan Zagura for... Oh, wait.
Did oh, my
you,
God.
You see this cable?
Oh, my God, Dave.
His mic wasn't.
We didn't even have him on microphone that whole time.
The microphone
time.
Wasn't in.
Oh, my God.
And you said you didn't want to take a picture with
oh
him.
My
I
God.
Said, let's take a picture with Nathan before he goes. You didn't even want to do that.
Can we Photoshop that?
I don't I'll know try. If I can. He was so nice. Oh, he took a picture on his phone. I remember he took a picture on his phone.
Nathan,
we said, yeah, just
listening.
Send it to me. Yeah, Nate, hit us up on Twitter, at Friday Fumble. That'd be great.
This is my nightmare.
Maybe it got picked up on one. I'll try to do it in post, but I don't have a way to edit the interview out, and I'm not just going to leave that out. Anyway, if you want to follow us on Twitter, at Friday Fumble, we'll try to keep you going through the game. Boy, this is really depressing now.
Yeah. Go Browns.
Go Browns, I guess. We'll try to salvage our career from this flaming wreck.
And my professional life.
Yeah. All right, well, my name's Dave.
I'm Dylan.
This has been your Browns Friday Fumble.
Friday, gotta get down on Friday. Everybody's looking forward to the weekend. Weekend, Friday, Friday. Friday, everybody's looking forward to the weekend.